Good day and welcome to Mission Control Houston. Today is Thursday, September 5, 2013, and this is Space Station Live. Here in the Mission Control Center, the team is watching over the activities of the Expedition 36 crew aboard the International Space Station. Commander Pavel Vinogradov, of course, continuing to work with NASA astronauts Chris Cassidy and Karen Nyberg, his Russian colleagues Fyodor Shikin and Alexander Mazurkin, and European Space Agency astronaut Luca Parmitano to conduct important research and maintain the International Space Station. We're starting our day today just a little bit late due to that interview by Chris Cassidy, and we'll have an opportunity later in the day to replay that for you. Today's activities are focused on more work with the SPHERES experiment. SPHERES stands for Synchronized Position Hold Engage Reorient Experimental Satellites, and the idea is to look at how small satellites can orient one another relative to themselves in microgravity. It's a very interesting experiment that actually had the genesis in the training droids that were used in the original Star Wars movie, and that was developed by the folks at the Massachusetts Institute of Technology into this experiment. Today's work is adding on some additional complexity to the SPHERES experiment with a smartphone helping to do the controlling and operations of the SPHERES. There are a lot of potential applications for this set of small satellites, both inside and outside the space station, one of which might be to use it as a personal assistant that could theoretically follow a crew member around within the space station and be able to allow them to access data and information about the activities that they need to perform or about communications activities, any kind of work that the crew might be doing at that time. They might have a little personal assistant that could be on the spot to help them out or provide some camera work over the shoulder, whatever. And we're testing whether smartphones could be used to do some of that activity. In addition, there's some maintenance work, plumbing, if you will, for Chris Cassidy on the schedule today. He's scheduled to be beginning soon to replace an air valve in the carbon dioxide removal system in the Tranquility module. That valve has been sticking for a while, and Mission Control has been able to work around the issue in terms of getting rid of the excess carbon dioxide inside the station atmosphere. But it's time now to replace that valve and see if we can't get the device to operate a little bit more smoothly without a lot of additional management. There are a couple of different carbon dioxide removal systems on the space station. One is on the U.S. side, one is on the Russian side. They use similar but differently designed equipment that provides what we call dissimilar redundancy, so that if one system fails for a specific reason, you don't necessarily have all of the systems that support carbon dioxide removal failing at the same time. So that'll be worked out. Of course, the carbon dioxide removal system, as you breathe, you inhale oxygen and nitrogen and you exhale carbon dioxide. This gets rid of the excess carbon dioxide and is also tied into some systems, the Sabatier, that are trying to eke a little bit more water recycling out of the atmosphere on the space station as well. The Japanese HTV-4 cargo ship, which departed from the International Space Station 11:20 a.m. Central Time yesterday, continues to phase away from the space station following yesterday's unberthing and release. It is scheduled to fire its engines to begin a destructive deorbit at 1:36 a.m. Central Time Saturday. NASA and the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency, which provided the cargo vehicle for the space station program, are working together to gather extensive data and imagery of the reentry, including some gathered by the crew and some by the iSurf science camera, which usually is applied to photographing natural disasters on Earth. But we'll be attempting to see if we can use that to provide some new data collection on exactly how items that are commanded to reenter the Earth do so. Pavel Vinogradov, Chris Cassidy, and Alexander Mazurkin are also continuing to load items and get ready for their departure in the TMA-08M Soyuz spacecraft. They're supposed to undock and land on the steppe of Kazakhstan next Tuesday. As we watch the coverage We're going to be having hatch closure coverage at 3 p.m. Central Time, undocking coverage beginning at 6:15 p.m. Central Time, landing coverage beginning at 8:45 p.m. Central Time, and we expect landing at 9:59 p.m. Central Time. After they have departed the space station, that leaves room for the next crew members to come up to the space station. Expedition 37 and 38 Prime crew members Mike Hopkins, Ola Kotov, and Sergei Rozansky are conducting their final round of Soyuz vehicle qualification exams today at the Gagarin Cosmonaut Training Center in Star City, Russia. A few photos of the trio as they get ready to depart for the final preparations for launch. Meeting executives from the Russian Federal Space Agency, getting ready to depart. Signing final qualification documents. Again, Hopkins, Kotov, and Rozansky are scheduled to launch to the International Space Station on September 25, and they're making final preparations at the training center in Star City now. That's what's going on aboard the International Space Station on Thursday, September 5, 2013.